Hello, welcome. In this video, we're trying to use laws of logarithms to break this thing down and simplify it. How can we do it? Even though it might look daunting, look around at your bases first, is usually what I do, and just keep thinking about them until you find some relation to the other numbers here. So if you play with the base of 2 enough, again, eventually you get that 2 to the 9th is 512. And if you play with the square root of 3 enough, the square root of 3, well, I know 3 to the 4th is 81, and the square root of 3 would have to be multiplied twice as many times. So I know the square root of 3, square root of 3 will have to be raised to the 8th power to get 81, and that's the x. So if that doesn't convince you, just think, okay, 3 times 3 times 3 times 3 is 81. So the square root of 3 has to be multiplied twice for each of these 3s, right? So if it takes 4 threes to multiply and make 81, it would take 8 square root of 3s to make the same number. All this comes together because our laws of exponents tell us that these things can come down in the front. The laws of logarithms tell us they can come down in the front, but also the laws of exponents tell us, take these two products, and then you get 7 times the log base 2 of 2 to the 9x plus log base square root of 3 of square root of 3 to the 8x, and then you can use your law of logs to bring these two things down in the front. And you get 9x, this is a 9, times the 7 times log base 2 of 2, plus 8x times the log base square root of 3 of the square root of 3. And what's nice now is that these two things are just 1. 2 to the first is itself, and the square root of 3 to the first is itself. And you get 63x plus 8x, and that's 71x. All right, hope that helped.